Phase 2 is almost here and people might think we're going completely blind into this. Not that there's anything wrong with that, it seems that the majority of players like this type of no beta, no testing, no nada content. I like it also, and mostly because it aligns with one of my favorite quotes.
Life was like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get.
The betas and PTRs kind of rob you from the initial magic that comes with new content, and for that reason, I believe people are willing to accept a couple of bugs or a class being overpowered for 1 week and welcome with open arms the unknown that comes with Season of Discovery. However, are we actually going completely blind into Phase 2? Not really. The foundation on which this game was built is one that was already figured out. Because of that and a couple of predictions and hints, today we are able to cover 7 things to expect in Phase 2 of Season of Discovery. So without further ado, let's get right into it, shall we? Mage portals instead of summons. Phase 1 was full of warlocks that made a small fortune playing 3 accounts in order to summon people to various locations for a small fee. People got so comfortable and lazy that warlocks were everywhere. South Shore, Ratchet, every major city, Ashenvale event, in every base, and so on. It's reported that some of these warlocks were making even 100 gold per day by providing summoning services. However, Phase 2 is going to break some of that market because mages are getting their portals. For a portal does not require 3 persons, and the reagent is quite inexpensive. Unfortunately, the Darnassus and Thunderbluff portals are only available at level 50, which means the summoning business is not going to be completely dead because people will still try to get their BFD world buff in time for raid. So if you're thinking to open a summoning business for Season of Discovery, you might be a little late to the party. Not only that the competition is high and you're competing with bots, but mages will definitely kill the business. Bots, gold buying, and a new rise and fall for the economy. Bots are here to stay, and not because Blizzard is not doing an effort to stop them, because they do. A couple of weeks ago, they banned 270,000 accounts that used exploits or simply sold gold. And as usual, a couple of innocent people also got caught in the process. For Phase 2, this is not going to stop, and I predict that due to the rise in popularity of Season of Discovery, an army of bots will return stronger than ever before. And this has something to do with the amount of gold recently bought by players. I know that we like to blame Blizzard for everything wrong with the game, but sometimes it's not just them. Gold buying used to be perceived as something frowned upon, or even something that might get you kicked out of a respectable guild. Nowadays, it's not the case anymore, and people are bragging about how much gold they bought, which is kind of crazy to me. Even big streamers got caught buying gold and admitted it in front of a large audience.
Yeah, Blizzard took all my gold. I bought gold. I mean, it wasn't a secret, and I got pretty fucked, so yeah, I lost all my gold. It was a lot.
Bro, at least he didn't get banned. Like, bro, he seems upset that he lost his gold, but like, bro, at least you didn't get banned, Soda.
I'm actually glad, in a way, that they are cracking down on bans, and I'm fucking lucky. So that's about where, yeah, I got off very easy. It's not.
With a new phase, we will see a change in the economy. First couple of weeks, prices will boom as people will get new raids, which require new consumables, new enchants, new materials required for acquiring runes, new big pots and gold EKPs, and not to mention the wave of epic BOEs such as Gut Reaper and Staff of Jordan, which will sell for a hefty price on the auction house. After a couple of weeks, the economy will probably collapse, at least on the mega servers such as Living Flame EU, which as the making of this video is still locked. I know I'm making this sound grim, but it's the reality. This shouldn't stop you from having fun at all. All I can ask is that you don't get sucked into gold buying, because each gold bot will summon an extra bot into Season of Discovery. It's no secret who are the classes that performed well in Phase 1, and it wasn't different from the original Classic. I guess that some classes just scale better than others. Every attempt for a class to beat warriors and rogues in PvE DPS was met with retaliation and nerfs from Blizzard. I guess we have to maintain the natural order of things. In Phase 2, I think we're going to see the rise of casters because Gnomer seemed to have a decent amount of elementals that might be immune to bleeds and poisons, making rogues and warriors less likely to be the top performing class when it comes to PvE DPS. Also, the Classic development team is aware of this and they started taking actions even from phase 1, reducing boss resistances by 50, adding more hit and spell power to the Black Phantom buff, and so on. Maybe the gear design for phase 2 will contain more stats that benefit caster DPS. It's my belief that phase 2 will be a caster phase, but I guess we will see soon. Level 40 cap and 31 talent points will make some classes really stand out both PvE and PvP. For example, the Elemental Shaman was lacking just too much at level 25. Phase 2, however, will give them not one but two ranks of Chain Lightning, Elemental Mastery, Lightning Mastery, Storm Reach, and if you take in account the new Nomar gear, they will be killing machines. Shadow Priest will get Shadow Form and become even scarier. Warriors Mortal Strike, but also Zerker Stance and Intercept, making the Warbringer rune a meme. Frost Mages with Fingers of Frost and Ice Barrier, oh boy. All this without even knowing the runes that are yet to be discovered. Based on memories from the original Classic Beta in 2019, the level 40 bracket was the most fun, and there's a high chance that history will repeat itself. Although level cap will be increased to level 40, people will still run the 25 raid BFD, because why shouldn't they? The last boss in BFD, Akumai, drops the pearl, which eventually rewards you with 3 trinkets. Trinkets that will probably be best in slot even in phase 2. Even let's say that Gnomer will have another trinket, obtainable either from a drop or from another quest, this will serve as the second best in slot, as there are not that many trinkets available in the level 40 cap. On top of that, BFD can drop a variety of items that are still quite viable in phase 2 and can serve as pre-best in slot for the Gnomer raid. Items like the helmets from the third boss, like the thinking cap, sets that provide set bonus, items with hit chance, and maybe the stuff that never drops, the epic stuff, which is actually better than a level 36 epic BOE Staff of Jordan. If we compare them one to one, you will see that the one from BFD has more intellect, for example. Other items such as the necklace from first boss with strength and agility, maybe the Twilight Lord set for warriors, which provides like defense rating and also strength and agility, stat combinations and set bonuses that are really hard to find before you enter Gnomer. The beauty about this is that you're gonna be able to run Gnomer at level 40, probably in 5 people or even less. Recently I saw a streamer doing BFD in 4 people, so at level 40 it's safe to say that in a normal group you will be able to clear it. Also, alts and fresh leveling characters will need to get that boon so the buff can keep on going on, so we could parse in Gnomer. Multiple ways of leveling. Leveling from 25 to 40 is something people get stressed about. You will see a lot of guides and preps on how to do it, fill a quest log with 20 completed quests, save Warsong Gulch marks, farm the specific items, and so on. In reality, level 25 to 40 should be even faster than 1 to 25, and that's because people already, let's just say, are twink geared from BFD and from the level 25 cap. You will be able to melt and destroy mobs on your path to level 40. We will have 10 layers, and these layers will have dynamic respawn timers, and if by any chance you completed all your quests for gold at level 25, there is another way. Dungeon grind should be an easy 1 level per hour early on, and the only thing you should worry about is not to clear the dungeon too fast, because you can only do 5 IDs per hour. We will witness the return of melee and spell cleave groups. Let me know in the comments what is the setup you would choose for a perfect dungeon grind group which has the best synergy. In the end, I guess, gathering some friends and spending a couple of hours clearing dungeons and also getting some upgrades might not be such a bad idea. Which brings us to another point, the unknown again. As Agren, the lead developer of Classic WoW, has stated that there will be other ways to level in phase 2. My guess would be that it will have to do something with a new event in Strangleton Vale, or maybe not. I guess we will be surprised when the patch hits. As for me, I have multiple characters to level, I will just take it on a nice pace, leveling them using rested XP through the course of a couple of weeks. Cause let's be honest, phase 2 is gonna be a long one and there's no rush. If you wanna give it a try, the add-on is free, 1 to 20, and there's a link in the description down below. Bada boom bada bam, be ready to welcome bugs with open arms. First place where we will encounter some friction will be class balance, with new level 40 spells and talents, but also some of the new and untested runes. During the first 2 weeks, expect to have a couple of nerfs to specific classes. My best guess is the Hunter again, but no one really knows who's gonna be the next victim. Basically, don't get too comfortable with your class being too overpowered. I have a feeling that the new Gnomer raid might have been developed in a rush. I'm basing this on the late release for Phase 2. I don't think the Classic team was expecting so much success for Season of Discovery. So expect a couple of broken mechanics, but just to be fixed ASAP. The Stranglethorn Vale PvP event is supposed to be completely different than Ashen Vale. Some hints that it will have to do something with the Blood God Hakkar. Some people speculate that you will be able to fight even your own faction for the last man standing, but one thing is for sure, there will be blood. And with so much new and untested content, there will be bugs and exploits. You just make sure to report them and not take advantage of them. New ways of dungeon farm and boost. You cannot have a phase 2 without a trade chat being spammed by boosters. Level 40 bracket opens the gates to new farms and new boosts for dungeons such as Scarlet Monastery, Uldaman, and Zul'Farak. During the first phase, we saw mages being able to boost efficiently walling caverns and stockades, and I'm not entirely sure if it will be possible to boost in Zul'Farak and Uldaman, as these dungeons have high-level mobs which will make the spell resists quite often. Reason why walling caverns and stockades works with boost, it's mostly because the mobs are within the level range. But if past equals future and there's a ledge to kite the mobs, most likely mages will figure something out. And to be honest, I wouldn't count the paladin out for being a potential booster or a good gold grinder because he was capable of clearing the Zul'Farak graveyard in the past. When it comes to general gold farms, professions will work great early on. Iron and mithril will sell great for people to level up engineering and blacksmith. Herbalism will be in high demand for the new waves of consumables required for progression in Gnomer. And in general, level 40 to 45 mob spots for Priebus greens, cloth, leather, and trade materials that could be useful for the new craftables in Phase 2. This is something I'm really looking forward to and can't wait to show you the new grinding spots. If you got so far in the video, it means you really enjoy my content. So I will let you know that I've opened a new YouTube channel, Frostadamus TV, which has a dedicated editor. The channel will contain highlights from my streams, covering news regarding Classic WoW and upcoming MMOs, and everything else regarding World of Warcraft. So if you're interested in this, hop on and subscribe so you won't miss anything. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, find me live at twitch.tv/frostadamus. With that being said, until our next encounter, stay frosty.